Look at this, guys.
Do you see something sticking out there?
I see an original green camouflage color. Bear with me and we're gonna dig this one out together.
Hey guys, today we're gonna go on an adventure in the Market Garden area. I'm meeting up with Walter Two Unknown and also Ray from the Dutch Relic Diggers is with us. Yeah, we have some foxholes in mind that we want to check out. So we're gonna get out those detectors and start digging. See you there. Right, I've been digging here for quite a bit now, and first I only had some weak iron signals, but that signal has just become a very high-pitched one, so we could be onto something here. I'm gonna keep digging and I'll keep you updated. Right, I've just hit some metal there, so let's see what that is. Right, some sort of can. Let's see if there's more. Well, I guess I got my answer. Let's keep on digging. Another iron object. Tool. Very rusted. I'm still working on this foxhole. It's getting deeper and deeper. Probably well over a meter already. And all the way down there, I had an iron signal. You can see it over there. I dug it out already. And here you can see it for yourself. Not much to see yet, but this is a live Amon Garand clip. Unfired one, packed with 8 rounds. I can already see that there's a black dot on the bullet tips, which means these are armor piercing rounds. But unfortunately it's live, so we're not gonna take this with us. Also, I just noticed that there is still some paper wrapped around this clip here, this here. Some parchment paper. Could be some writing on there as well, but just look at all this freaking rocks attached to it. But nevertheless, that's a very cool find. We're scouting a new area. You can see my buddies, they're metal detecting in the back over there. And I just noticed this very special dugout. Here you can see the entry, and it's a bigger hole right there. And there was actually a foxhole right next to it. Here, you can see how close that foxhole is to the bigger dugout. So I decided to excavate it a little bit, and I don't know, some glass, some metal parts, some glass came out. I think this is actually Bakelite, and there's for sure more signals in the hole. I just discovered some rounds. Here, look at that. You see that gold color over there? Let me just get that out. That's rounds, and I believe that these are German rounds. Here, check this out. It's quite a lot of them. So I'm definitely going to be excavating this foxhole a little bit further. That's a Mauser K98K stripper clip. It's 4 rounds still on them. All right, Ray just confirmed that ammo we found is German. And Ray also pointed out that this, well, I think it's a piece of Bakelite. You can see these lines in it, these grooves, and it's like roundish. We think it's from an LP. Look how cool that is. So they might have played some music here and shot at some people, I guess. We found a second part of this LP plate, some tubes. This is the lid of some glassware, some German glassware, very neat still. And I just spotted something non-metal, and some of you might recognize this. I found this before in a previous video when I was on the Eastern Front. I found a dump pit full of these. And this is actually a cap that went on the muzzle end of a Mauser K98K rifle, German rifle. So this was to protect the barrel, basically. So that's a nice little find. Oh yeah, I found more of these LP plates and also a second of these Mauser K98K caps, protection caps. Quite a funny moment here just now. Ray said he found a silver spoon, but it isn't your usual spoon. Look how massive this thing is, and it weighs a ton as well. There were markings on it, right?
Right there.
90. 90% silver? Who knows?
I hope.
You can always melt this, you know, and get a paycheck from it. Nice find. Guess they had some soups in this forest, these soldiers.
Me and Ray discovered some foxholes. Perhaps you can see some of them. There's one there, also one back there. And we are digging in one right here. And I did get quite some iron signals, so we decided to just start digging. And the first item to pop up is an American find. This is a heater element for soldiers to eat soup, like a soup heater. They would put this in a can of soup and they would light the candle here. And yeah, the soup would get warm, they could eat it. So far we've only found some of those US soup rations. Still more signals there though. These four soup heaters we dug up already. They're still unused.
Do you want to get your hands on exclusive World War II artifacts and support us while you're at it? Experience the history that took place on the battlefield by buying a unique set of relics. Go and check out the brand new relic packages that are now available in our webshop.
Some time has passed, but we're back at it. World War II artifacts also joined the game. We're at a new location that we're gonna try out. So without further ado, let's get going. Ray called me over. He had a huge object in his hands. Jesus, man. What is that, a gas burner?
I think so, some kind of burner. Huh?
Wow, this part here looks really old. What's that, brass? Could easily be from the Second World War. I don't recognize it immediately. I've never found something like that before, but oh, there's some writing on there too. Barthel, it says. Well, maybe somebody recognizes this, but we're gonna do some research for sure and if it's something cool, then I'll definitely let you know.
This German gas burner was used to heat up essential parts of motorized armored vehicles in cold conditions. They were mostly used in winter campaigns.
The guys from World War II Artifacts just had a hit. A Flak shell casing, I think 37 millimeters, right?
Yes, it is.
Anti-aircraft. We found these before in the past. Also, this is an iron version, but still very cool. So, I bet this is not the only shell casing that's gonna be here, so let's see if you can find some more. Okay, so that was indeed definitely not the only Flak shell casing that was buried here. There's yet another one. And I don't think we're done yet. That's the sound we wanna hear. Yes, there we go. Hope there's gonna be some brass ones in there too. Nice.
So, there's another one?
Yeah. Well, then surely they must have had some gun here, some gun emplacement here. Nice. Yeah, unfortunately, they're all iron, but. Four pieces already. Nice job.
The 3.7 centimeter Flak is a fully automatic anti-aircraft cannon with a firing rate of 80 rounds per minute. They were used for both aerial defense and ground support. Operation of the gun required a crew of 6 to 7 soldiers. Aircrafts could effectively be shut down up to a height of about 4 kilometers. It was put into practice in 1936 and used until the end of the war.
Jeff from World War II Artifacts is working on quite a deep hole here. He called me over, he said he had a deep iron signal. Or, well, at least there were a lot of iron parts. And he already dug this out. And we believe that this is a helmet liner. So this would have been round and it would have been placed on the inner side of the helmet. And you can see two leather parts sticking out. So yeah, we really hope that the helmet is gonna be also in that hole, but I guess we're gonna find out. I see that Jeff is digging a little bit harder after just finding this, so I think we're gonna see soon if there's more in there. So we've already seen another
helmet liner part, it's sticking out somewhere over there. Yeah, right there. So yeah, we're not sure if there is gonna be a helmet in there, or if it is, maybe it's in pieces.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, that. Yeah, that's the, isn't that the chin strap from a helmet?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. You guys see that piece of leather there? I think that went under the chin. Let me get you down there. Here, that's the part I'm talking about, in the middle of the screen. Wow. Man, I hope this helmet is gonna be in one piece. It must be in there, for sure. Is that a helmet part?
I think so.
Oh yeah. Man, no way. Well.
So sad that it's broken.
Yeah, it's beat up for sure. Let's see if we can save some of those parts. Maybe there's markings on there.
So okay. I think it is, I'm not completely sure. But looks like it.
Well, maybe there is a second one in a better condition down there. Well, this helmet has definitely seen better times. We actually believe that it could be a British paratrooper helmet because the leather part is super similar. Wow, that would be a really cool find, man.
Could really be.
Wow.
Yeah.
I've never seen that before, that's for sure. The British Airborne Forces consisted of parachute troops and glider-borne troops of all arms of service. These forces consisted of a variety of parachute and air landing regiments. The early British paratrooper helmets were first introduced in 1942. This type of helmet was designed to be worn when jumping out of a plane, meaning the helmet had a tight fit to make sure they don't come off. To make the helmet even more secure, the chin strap was designed to be a part of the leather liner. Jeff comes walking over very casually with a complete belt in his hands, and I think this buckle is a British webbing buckle. I'm not sure what belt exactly, but yeah, that's a cool relic. Ray just found this British 2-inch mortar piece of ammunition. Yeah, as you can see, the paint is still on there. There's a red stripe. I'm not sure what type that indicated, but it's like green and with a red line here. So it's preserved really well. But yeah, I mean, ammunition, unfortunately. So we're gonna mark the location, and we're trying to do our job to make the woods a safer place. So we will report this, and the woods will be a bit safer again. We were almost at the point of giving up, and we actually just put our stuff right here. We thought, let's move one more time, and I had a signal right over there where you can see my shovel. It was a 66 signal, and I thought that was quite promising, and I think I wasn't wrong. Look at this, guys. Let me see over there. Do you see something sticking out there? All right, let me just get you down there. The sun is actually shining nicely on it. You see this here? God missed that. I see an original green camouflage color. And bear with me, and we're gonna dig this one out together. Look at that. Well, I can for sure get it out already, but I mean, look at those original green colors. I think this one is in a really nice condition. Let's get this off. Shall we get it out? This must be one of the nicest canteens that I've found so far. I found one of those green ones, which are British. You also had blue ones, those were Canadian. I have one of both, but this is the prettiest one for sure. Wow, let me get my brush. Right, let's save the coordinates and look carefully around this area, because there must be more, I'm sure. Well, we got ourselves a small mystery box over there. Let me just get it. Just duck this out. And I don't know, it's a small box, and it almost looks like there's a keyhole on the bottom here. And here you could lift it up with your finger. I'm not sure if there's something in it, but definitely looks like a World War II item. So let's open it up later on and see what it is. It turns out that this is a British marked razor box.
Well, that's that. Yeah, it was a really cool day in the Markham Garden area. I had a lot of fun with my friends, and I want to say thank you especially to my patrons for supporting the channel. If you want to see more exclusive behind the scenes content, go check out my Patreon. Link is in the video description. See you guys. Cheers.